At the end of this topic, you will be able to define living and non-living things, discriminate non-living things from living things in day-to-day life, state the salient features of living things. Things that have life are called living things. Example, plants, animals, and human beings. Things that do not have life are called non-living things. Example, rock, book, water, etc. Living things possess the following features. Living things' body is made up of cells and they are the structural and functional units of life. They need food for various life activities. They respire, consume oxygen, and convert food into energy. They grow at certain stages of life. Plants' growth is unlimited, but animals' growth is limited. They respond to the stimuli caused from external environments. They reproduce their own kind to keep the race alive. They have a lifespan for the definite period of time. For example, man's average lifespan in India is 70.
In this topic, you have learnt
living things have life, but non-living things do not. Plants, animals, and human beings are living entities, and rock, book are non-living things. Living things possess the features like growth, reproduction, respiration, etc. Their body is made of cells. They respond to stimuli, and they have definite period of lifespan. At the end of this topic, you will be able to tell what habitat means, outline the importance of habitat, classify the different types of habitats for plants, categorize the subtypes in hydrophytes, explain how mesophytes stand in between hydrophytes and xerophytes, identify the xerophytes, analyze the features of xerophytes. Place of living is called a habitat. Plants live in different habitats such as water, land, desert, hills, etc. Plants adjust themselves to the place where they live, survive well, and reproduce. A habitat provides them food, shelter, suitable climate for survival and reproduction. In 1909, Warming classified the plants into three types on the basis of their water requirement, and they are hydrophytes, mesophytes, xerophytes. Hydrophytes means plants live in water. Hydro is equal to water and phytes is equal to plants. These plants live in the water bodies like ponds, lakes, wetlands, streams, and rivers. They are divided into three types, namely free floating hydrophytes, attached floating hydrophytes, and submerged hydrophytes. Plants which float freely on the water surface are called free floating hydrophytes. Example, water hyacinth. Plants which are fixed at the bottom of the pond and the leaves float on the surface of the water are generally called as attached floating hydrophytes. Example, water lily, ali. Plants which are completely submerged, that is underwater and rooted in the mud, are called submerged hydrophytes. Example, vallisneria. Hydrophytes have following adaptations to acquaint with the water bodies. Root system is either poorly developed or completely absent. Stem is thick, short, and spongy with air spaces to float in water. Leaves have a waxy coat which prevents their decay in excess water. Mesophytic plants grow in places with moderate water supply, as they neither grow in places with too much of water nor in the places with too little water. Most of the crop plants are mesophytes. Example, wheat, maize, sunflower, mango, neem. Mesophytes have well-developed root system. Leaves of mesophytes are usually large and broad. Xerophytes means desert plants. Xero is equal to desert and phytes is equal to plants. Plants which grow in dry areas are called xerophytes. Xerophytes' body is adapted to cope with the water scarcity, high temperature, strong winds, etc. Example, opuntia, chapati kali. Xerophytes have long roots which go deep into the ground in search of water. In opuntia, the stem is modified into thick, flat, and green leaf-like structure and does photosynthesis. Real leaves are reduced or modified into spines to prevent the water loss.
In this topic, you have learnt
place of living is called habitat, and plants live in different habitats such as water, desert, hill, etc., and adjust to the environment, survive well, and reproduce well. In 1909, Warming classified the plants based on their water requirement into three types, namely hydrophytes, mesophytes, xerophytes. Hydrophytes live in water and divided into three types, namely free floating, where plants float freely on the water surface, attached floating where the plant fixed at the bottom of the pond, and the leaves alone float on the surface of the water, and submerged hydrophytes where the plant is completely underwater. Hydrophytes have the adaptations like poorly developed root, thick, short and spongy stem-like S spaces to float in water, and waxy-coated leaves to prevent the decay. Mesophytes grow in places with moderate water supply, and most of the crop plants are mesophytes and they have well-developed root system with large and broad leaves. Plants which grow in dry areas are called xerophytes, and they have long roots, modified stem for photosynthesis and leaves to prevent the water loss.
At the end of this topic, you will be able to describe the root system, state the functions of the root system. The root develops from the radical of the seed and grows towards the soil. In general, roots grow underground and have hair-like structures called root hairs. Unlike shoots, roots do not have nodes or internodes. Types of roots. Roots are of two types, taproot and fibrous root. Click the name of a root type to know more. The root that develops from the radical and grows vertically towards the soil forms the main root. From the main root, other sub-branches arise, which are called secondary roots and tertiary roots. The primary root and its branches constitute the taproot system. Example, mango tree, balsam plant. In some plants, a bunch of roots develop from the point where the stem touches the ground. They constitute the fibrous root system. Example, grass and paddy. Functions of root. The primary function of the root is to fix the plant in the soil. It helps in absorption of water and minerals. It helps in storing food. It conducts water. It also helps in photosynthesis and respiration.
In this topic, you have learnt the part of the plant which grows under the soil is called the root system. The radical of the embryo grows deep into the soil and becomes the primary root. Roots that grow from any part of the plant other than the radical are called adventitious roots. Roots absorb water and minerals from the soil and transport them to the stem.
At the end of this topic, you will be able to discuss the shoot system, list down the functions of the shoot system. The stem. The stem is a part of the plant that grows vertically above the surface of the soil. It is the part that arises from the plumule of the seed. It has nodes, internodes, leaves, flowers and fruits. Functions of the stem. The main function of the stem is to spread its branches. It bears leaves, flowers and fruits. It conducts water and mineral salts. Some stem stores food. The stem provides mechanical strength to the plants. It also helps in vegetative propagation.
In this topic, you have learnt the part of the plant which grows above the ground is called shoot system. The shoot consists of main stem with branches, nodes, internodes, leaves, buds, flowers and fruits. The distance between two successive nodes is called internode. At the end of the topic, you will be able to draw the parts of a leaf, list the functions of leaf.
Leaves are green in color. They are flattened structures borne on the stem. A leaf has three main parts. They are leaf base, petiole and leaf blade, which is otherwise known as the lamina. Functions of leaf. Leaves prepare food material by the process called photosynthesis. They regulate the intake of oxygen and carbon dioxide. They also regulate transportation of water and mineral salts. They help a plant survive weather changes by modifying themselves. They also help in vegetative propagation.
In this topic, you have learnt leaf is thin, broad, flat and green part of the plant. The leaf blade is the expanded part of the leaf which is green in colour. It has a midrib in the centre of the leaf blade. The stalk of the leaf is called petiole. The loss of excess water from the leaf in the form of water vapour through stomata is called transpiration. At the end of the topic, you will be able to draw parts of a flower, list the functions of a flower.
The flower. The flower is the reproductive part of the plant. The flower is located at the axil of the stem or at the apex of the stem. It has a stalk called the pedicel. The stalk may be short or long. The upper part of the pedicel is swollen or conical, which leads to the region called the thalamus or the receptacle. The thalamus is the base of the flower on which the floral organs are arranged. Floral parts. On the thalamus of the flower, the floral parts are arranged in four whorls. They are calyx, corolla, andrecium, and gynecium. Functions of a flower. A flower is involved in various functions as follows. It holds the reproductive organs of the plant. It helps in pollination, develops into fruit and seeds, and contains nectar which attracts insects. A flower also adds beauty to nature by its pleasant looks.
In this topic, you have learnt flower is called the reproductive part of a plant because it helps in its sexual reproduction. A flower has four main parts, calyx, corolla, andrecium, and gynecium. Each stamen consists of a stalk called filament and a bag-like structure on the top of the filament called anther. The main function of the flower is reproduction.
At the end of this topic, you will be able to explain movement in plants, outline the types of movement in plants, describe various types of movement with examples, analyze the movement in touch-me-not plant. Plants are generally sedentary and they do not move from place to place, but the parts of the plants show growth movements in response to some stimuli like sunlight, water, soil, etc. The tendency of the plant parts to grow towards or away from the direction of stimuli is called tropism. Plants' movement is broadly classified into two categories. Tropic movement is movement of the part with the direction of the stimulus and influences the growth, phototropism, movement towards light, geotropism, movement towards earth, hydrotropism, movement towards water. Gnostic movement is movement of the part is not concerned with the direction of the stimulus and does not influence the growth. The movement of the part of the plant in response to light is called phototropism. When the part of the plant moves towards the stimulus of light is called as positively phototropic. Example, stem. When the part of the plant moves away from the stimulus of light is called as negatively phototropic. Example, root. The movement of part of the plant in response to gravity is called geotropism. When the part of the plant moves towards the stimulus of gravity, it is called as positively geotropic. Example, root. When the part of the plant moves away from the stimulus of gravity, it is called as negatively geotropic. Example, stem. The movement of the part of the plant in response to water is called hydrotropism. When the part of the plant moves towards water, it is called as positively hydrotropic. Example, root. When the part of the plant moves away from the stimulus of water, it is called as negatively hydrotropic. Example, stem. The non-directional and irregular movement of plant part is called gnostic movement, which does not influence the growth. Good example for gnostic movement is the movement in touch-me-not plant. Mimosa pudica responds to touch by folding up and drooping down its leaves for the sense of touch.
In this topic, you have learnt
plants are sedentary, but the individual parts move in response with external stimuli and the movement is broadly classified into tropic and gnostic movement. Tropic movement is movement of the part of the plant with the direction of the stimulus, and gnostic movement is movement of the part which is not concerned with the direction of the stimulus. Types of tropism. Phototropism, movement towards light, shoot. Geotropism, movements towards earth, root. Hydrotropism, movement towards water, root. Gnostic movement is expressed well in touch-me-not plant as it folds or drops its leaves while touching it.